In today's video, we're doing a tutorial. Welcome to the video, guys. My name is Tyler, also known as the Fit Chemist, and I help people take control of their lives by taking control of their fitness and nutrition habits so that we can ultimately lead a healthier and happier life. So if you are new here, please consider subscribing and turning the notifications on so you don't miss when I post a video. And if you're returning, welcome back. I am so glad you're here. We recently finished the How to Diet series, and throughout the series, I would frequently mention that I did have some free spreadsheets for you guys to download. So this is an invitation. If you have not already, pause the video. They are linked down below. Go download the spreadsheets. There are two of them. One is a nutrition calculator spreadsheet in which I have a bunch of different tabs for all these different things for you to calculate, which is what we're going to walk through today. And then another one is a calorie tracking spreadsheet that I've adopted from Holly Baxter and sort of modified it to my liking, and that will be the video topic for next week's video. We'll eventually do a walkthrough of that, but today, full walkthrough of the nutrition calculators. I think they're pretty self-explanatory, but just in case, we'll give some clarifications and I will show you step by step how to use each tab in that spreadsheet. So again, if you haven't already, go download that now. I'm gonna hop over to my computer and I will meet you in the spreadsheet. Okay, as you can see, we are on the home page of the spreadsheet. So you can see all these wonderful things that are included, some of the instructions on how to use this. So if you were to download this and you're not watching this video, but since you're here, that's not really gonna be of much use to you. And then some of the sources. So, you know, obviously you need to give credit where credit is due. One thing I do wanna point out is that you'll notice across the bottom here that all of these sheets are locked. And I've done that on purpose because I don't want you guys editing. There's a lot of formulas and stuff in the different cells. And if you mess up one of those formulas, everything else in that particular sheet is gonna be messed up. You'll have to come back, re-download this. So trust me, just leave it as is. If you really do need to change something or you're interested in the formulas, what you can do is come up here under the review tab, click unprotect sheet. So then you can click on whatever you need to change it or just look at it if you want. Then you can come back to this review tab, click protect sheet, and then just make sure select unlocked cells is the only box checked. And then after you do so, hit okay, and it'll relock the sheet. So we can see down here that lock symbol is back, and then you can't change anything. So we can start with the Muller equation tab. So I did a maintenance calorie video. So if you're interested, go watch that. But the things you need to know for this are your weight in pounds, that'll convert it to your weight in kilograms, what your current body fat percentage is, and your age. I'll just go ahead and plug in my data from this morning. So I was 166. I think my body fat was around 14%. My age is 25. So we'll plug in those three variables. We'll get a predicted BMR or basal metabolic rate. And then we have our activity factors. So I'd say I'm probably very active or moderate active, but you can see that it comes over here and it gives you your predicted maintenance. So, you know, this is just a rough ballpark. Again, what I like to do is actually use my own data. So we can jump into, let's say, the diet break maintenance tab. We'll come back to the macros tab. This one, again, is using your own data. So let's say you diet for like 3 weeks. So we'll put that duration in, 3 weeks. Let's say over those 3 weeks that we lost 4 pounds. Let's say my average calorie intake over those 3 weeks was 3,100 calories. So that would give me an average deficit per day of 511, and that would tell me that my maintenance calories are actually 3611. So that one's pretty self-explanatory, pretty quick to use. So you would use that if you had been dieting for a couple weeks and you lost weight. That's quite similar to this maintenance from a deficit tab, except this other tab here has a little bit more formulations in it. I guess you could say it's a little bit more accurate because it actually takes into account weight lost from both fat mass and lean body mass. If you remember from the video, we sort of talked about that, but let's just stick with that current example. Let's say I lost 4 pounds. This time we put it as 21 days instead of 3 weeks. And then again, let's just say that my maintenance was 3,100 calories. So I would say that my maintenance is actually 3,778 calories. So you can see it's slightly different than this diet break maintenance. I think this tab is a little bit more accurate, and that's probably the one that I would use. Again, I'll show you guys how to change this here. I don't really like this rounding, so So I'm going to unprotect the sheet, select those two, click format cells, come down to number, and how many decimals do I want? We'll just go zero. Okay, so that's changed. Then we would go to protect sheet. Again, make sure select unlock cells is checked. And there you have it. So you can see that I have these little like post-it note pop-ups. So if you don't want to come back and watch this video, when you click something, if you're not really sure what it is, you can just see if there's a post-it note and it should tell you what to do. So let's say that you did go through this, I guess, dieting phase and you were tracking your calories, trying to figure out your maintenance, and you didn't lose weight, but you actually ended up gaining weight. So then you would come to this maintenance from a surplus tab. So all we would do, let's say I gained 2 pounds and this was over, we'll say 14 days. And let's say my calorie intake again was 3,100. So it would tell me that I was in an average surplus per day of 401 calories, which means my predicted maintenance would be 2,699 calories. So personally, I like these three tabs down here the best because again, it is using your own data. This Muller equation tab is a good ballpark, but it's not as accurate. So you can use whatever you want. And just remember that our bodies are complex machines. Like, these are not going to be perfect. They're very good in terms of using your own data, but again, you know, you just have to track, see what happens to your body, and adjust accordingly. So with that, we can come back to the macros tab. So let's say, okay, I'll put in my data here. I'm 166 pounds. Let's go back to this maintenance from deficit tab and see what we had. So this predicted, get out of there. This predicted our maintenance was 3,778 calories. So I'm gonna plug that into the macros tab. Let's say we're rolling with that. Okay, so then I'll have this little note here. So if you are interested and you wanna see more about these recommendations and the science behind them, go ahead and watch the macros video. That's where I got these recommendations. But I put in some protein multipliers here. I would suggest anywhere between 0.8 and 1 as your protein multiplier. Maybe a little bit higher if you're in a pretty severe deficit, just to have some extra amino acids in the system. I typically like to go for 1. I think it's a good ballpark number. So that would tell me that I need to eat 166 grams of protein per day. It'll tell me how many calories are responsible for that. So just 166 times 4, that's how we get this number. And that tells me how many calories I have remaining for carbs and fats. And then you come down here and you would basically just click on whatever carb and fat ratio. Let's say you want a 1-to-1 ratio, it would give you your macros down here. Personally, I eat around this 70-30 split. Let's say you're on something like a keto diet, you can scroll down to like 595 or like 0% carbs. I would say 0%, it's pretty hard to do because even vegetables have small amounts of carbs in them. So I don't know, you can come here, pick whatever you want. I'll go 70-30. So let's say I choose that. My new macros would be 166 protein, 545 grams of carbs, and then 104 grams of fat each day. We can then come to the how long to diet tab. I think this one is quite important because remember, we want to select a rate of weight loss that is appropriate. If we diet too fast, we're going to lose too much muscle, and we don't want to do that. So what we would do is, let's say, I'll just make up some numbers like I was starting a prep. Let's say I was at 180 pounds to start. My body fat was, I don't know, let's say 16, and I wanted to get down to 4% body fat. So you can see this little pop-up here. Don't include the percent sign. So I've set up the calculations to just put in the absolute number and not the percentage. So be sure that you do that, because otherwise all the other numbers will be off. But I've done that. And then let's see. Let's say my contest prep, I want it to be 25 weeks. So that would give me a required rate of weight loss of 0.6 kilograms per week, and a rate of weight loss in terms of a percentage is 0.7%. And that falls into this category, or I guess it falls into the range, the recommended range of fat loss between 0.4 and 0.8% of your body weight. So again, I've done a video on this. So if you want to know more about that and why these recommendations are there, you can go ahead, watch that video. Let's say I didn't want it to be 25 weeks. Let's say initially I wanted it to be 12 weeks. That would say that my percentage of weight loss would be 1.4% of my body weight per week. That is outside of the range. We do not want to do that. So you can just sort of play around with this, put in the number of weeks until you get to whatever rate of weight loss is appropriate for you. Something else that people also like to do, not everyone has a target body fat percentage. I think this is the most accurate way to do it if you're doing a contest prep or something like that. But let's just say you want to lose like 10 pounds. What you could do is just sort of like play around with these numbers. So right now you can see that we have to lose a required weight loss. I'll get that. Showing that we have to lose a required weight loss of 9 or basically 10 kilograms. So that would be 22 pounds. So if I put in 22 here, that would give me 10 kilograms, which is basically the same as this 9.8. So let's say you didn't want to like play around with body fat. We could put it as like 10%. So that means we would need to lose, let's say, 5 kilograms. So I could come over here. Basically just play around with the number of pounds. And this would be what, maybe like 10, I'll say 12. Oh, I'm meeting in the middle, it'll be 11. So we need to lose 11 pounds to lose that. And then that puts our rate of weight loss at 0.3. So again, if you're not really interested in the target body fat percentage, you can just put in whatever numbers you want and play around with this until you get the desired rate of weight loss. So again, this person would be wanting to lose 11 pounds in 25 weeks. And that's an appropriate rate of loss. I'd say it's kind of slow, but you know, up to you, your discretion. So once we've done this and we've done the how long to diet tab and we know our rate of weight loss, we can come over to our daily deficit, and this will tell us how many calories we need to eat on a daily basis to lose weight at that rate of weight loss. So we can come here. So let's say we went with the initial example that was 0.7 kilograms per week, plug that in. Let's say I calculated my maintenance calories from one of the other tabs to be, let's say 2,800. So it would tell me what my daily deficit from both fat mass and lean body mass has to be. So it's about 600 calories. This would tell me, excuse me, that I need to eat about 2,200 calories per day to lose the weight. So once you do this, then again, you can go back into the macros tab, figure out how many macros you need to be eating each day. And then the last tab that I have not done a video on yet, but I will be doing one shortly, is reverse dieting. So reverse dieting is essentially after a diet period, you're just gonna add in small amounts of calories and basically raise your metabolism up while trying to mitigate fat gain. Because remember, our body adapts when we're in a diet. It starts to slow down, and eventually our new maintenance is not the same as our old maintenance. We wanna bring that maintenance back up. So reverse dieting is a way that we can do that. So let's say I was eating, I don't know, 2,500 calories at the end of my diet. So once I plug that in, it'll tell me how many calories I should increase each day based on what type of reverse diet I'm doing. So I have conservative, moderate, and aggressive, and all of the descriptors are down here. These are from Lane Norton's The Complete Reverse Dieting Guide. So if you're really interested in reverse dieting, you can go ahead and check out his book. It is a great read. But yeah, it tells you all the calories that you need to increase. So let's say I wanna go with moderate at 5%. That means I need to increase my calories 125, and my new calories to be eating every day would be 2,625. So once I do that, I would come down here and pick that 5% multiplier, because that's the one that I wanted up here. But again, it would tell me I need 125 calorie increase. And then what I would do is I would pick my desired carb and fat ratio. So we will be increasing calories from carbs and fats since our body weight should be somewhat stable. So let's say I'm sitting at 166. Once I plug in these numbers for a reverse diet, my protein is gonna stay around 166 for quite some time. Even if my body weight goes up to like 175, I think eating 166 grams of proteins is still pretty close to 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight per day. So again, we're just gonna increase our calories from carbs and fats. So let's say I just want it strictly from carbs, I would say 100, so that would give me 31 grams of carbs. Let's say I want half and half, come down here to 50-50, so I get a 16 gram of carb bump per day, and then 7 grams of fat. Or if you just wanted it all from fat, you can come down here and click that. So again, personal preference, it's up to you. All right guys, that is it for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Next week, we'll be doing something very similar, but we'll be walking through my calorie tracking spreadsheet. So again, if you're new here, consider subscribing and turning the notification bells on so you don't miss when that video goes live. If you did get some value out of this and you did enjoy the video, please give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below. It does help me out with the YouTube algorithms. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.